Hello, welcome to the shell scripting tutorial. This is the third tutorial in this series. So in this video session we are going to learn about Linux directory structure. Okay, so what is the important of Linux directory structure and why we need the Linux directory structure to learn? Okay, so Linux directory structure in Linux operating system to know is very important for us to because what is the files? So the files are segregated in such a manner that the files are segregated with the different directories. Okay, so executable in one directory and the different user home files and in different directories, something like that. Okay, so if you see the Linux directory structure, then only you can understand that okay this is the directory structure we have. Okay, which files will store where. Okay, so that information you will get it here. Okay, so this is about the typically we have this many Linux directories by default whenever you install the operating systems. Okay, this will be you can able to see here. Okay, slash bin is the directory where the all the executable files for the users, okay, which is not normal users can be execute the commands like the cd or the ls, okay, cat, touch. So these all the commands by executed by the users will be stored under this bin directory. Okay, so boot directory is store the boot information and the boot configuration files. Okay, and dev is the directory where it will store and special files like device files such as DVD, CD, the thumb drive, whatever you attach here. So the different suppose say if you have any tape drives attached to your system, so that those device files will be there in the dev directory. Okay, and slash etc will having the all the configuration files, such as any configuration files you may want to edit, like the configuration files for the SSH or the configuration files for the user environment, something like that. So all the configurations will be stored under the slash etc directory. Okay, slash home directory is made for the users to store their user directories. Okay, under the slash home is in a path to where whenever you create a new user, by defaultly the user directory home path will be created under the slash home, so that those individual users can store their own directory data, something like that. We have user data in that, they can store into the slash home. Okay, so the lib and lib64, we have a library files where we have compiled the system executable files. Okay, and slash media slash mnt is the optional directories which are just created and will be available for us to mount any like the mount point. If you want to create suddenly want to mount something like the thumb drive, you have just attached it and you want to mount that thumb drive, so no need to create an extra directory. Slash media slash mnt, you can just use it to mount and use it for the mounting purpose. Okay, slash opt is an optional directory, like where whenever you install any third party softwares, okay, like such as Chrome or something, like wherever the third party software you installed, those related files will be stored under the slash opt directory. Okay, slash proc directory will be there the system related information stuff, like the where if you want to verify your memory information, like how much memory I have on my system, or the how much CPU, in the sense how many CPUs are there. Okay, those system related information will be stored under the slash proc directory. Okay, slash root directory is only for the root user, in the sense of the super user. Whenever you install an operating system, so the root user will be created, that root user home directory is slash root. Okay, slash run is in a directory when you attach any other devices. So when you have an auto mount option, under slash run the directories will be auto mounted. Okay, slash sbin is an again the we have the executable files, such as the super user only can execute these files, like such as mount, fdisk, those commands like related super user commands will be stored under the slash sbin. Okay, slash sys is the directory where we have the system related configuration files or the system related information, such as suppose if you want to execute the some device scanning, something like that. So those related executable files will be there in the slash sys directory. Okay, slash temp is the directory where we have only the temporary files to be stored. Okay, you do not store any important information on the slash temp. Suppose if you have downloaded some of the softwares to test it or software to be installed, then you can just download into the slash temp and install it and just delete it. Okay, likewise temporary, if you want to store something, you can just store under the slash temp. So this slash temp will have the full permissions to the all users, but the special permissions you have this slash temp is the sticky bits sticky bit permission. So whenever the user is copied, the user can only be delete the information related to him, or if you reboot your system, so that directory will be cleared after that. Okay, slash usr is an a local directory where it stores an information about the installed softwares. Okay, whenever you install a local software in your system, so the slash usr directory will be stored the related configuration files or the related binary files in the slash usr. Slash var is an having the variable data, such as logs. Okay, logs in the sense, so all the log information will be available under the slash var directory. Okay, this is the basic stuff. Why we want to know these structures? Because so whenever you are making some of the commands using your shell scripting, so where you want to keep it, like you want to make it as a super user availability or you want to make it as a regular user availability, so that based on the directory, so where you want to keep. So if you made an important command and you just go to the put on the slash temp directory, then there is no use, right? So it will be deleted after the server reboot. So you should know that which directory is important for us and where which files will be kept under the which directory. So that's why this important us to know the directory structure. Okay, so please follow us our social links. Here is the Facebook, Reddit and Pinterest and Google Plus. So for more updates and related topics. So if you still have any questions or if you want to give us the feedback, you are very much welcome. You can just send us an email to this mentioned email address, so that if you have any queries also, we can just try to address as soon as possible. Okay, thanks. Please subscribe to the channel, follow the series of tutorial. Enjoy.